making cars moves us. What moves you?
In this case, with this type of a purchase, any purchase over $500,000 has to go through the Attorney General's review. And we successfully went through that review, and we didn't have any issues with the Attorney General's office.
The OPA Friday issued a decision upholding Morrico Equipment's procurement protest over the awarding of a contract to purchase two fire trucks to Far East. Far East won over the bids of Morrico and Midpack. The decision means the contract will have to be rebid. Palm Fire spokesman Lieutenant Ed Artero called the OPA's decision unfortunate.
It's a little bit unfortunate on the issue with the fire truck specifications because it's such a necessary equipment for the Guam Fire Department and for the community of Guam. And, you know, we're up against a grant timeline. So now with this protest, we're definitely going to have to make a formal request for an extension so that we can properly go through this bid process to get these trucks here.
The OPA ruled that Guam procurement law was violated because the invitation to bid included what the OPA concluded was two costly and unnecessary inspection trips for two Guam Fire employees.
The trips are a necessary part of the acquisition. In every major purchase that we've had with ambulances and fire trucks in the past, an inspection is part of the process to validate that the specs are met. And the fact that it's such a very big purchase, we don't want to wait for the equipment to get here and refuse it when we can do everything prior to that.
So you weren't trying to sneak this in and bury it in there so nobody would know. You always do these trips, right?
Yeah, we always do these trips. It's a necessary part of the process.
The Guam Public Auditor also faulted the IFB for restricting competition by setting a 240-day completion deadline, which only Far East said they could meet.
In our opinion, if one vendor was able to meet the delivery date, then it proves that it wasn't unreasonable. We felt that because one person met the delivery date, then it should be upheld.
The funds for the two fire trucks are part of $2 million in compact impact funds that must be committed by September.
The decision is out of our hands. Our next course of action is to work with GSA, work with OPA's office to make sure that her recommendations are addressed, and we may have to just reissue the specs and redo the bid all over again.
Kevin Kerrigan, PNC News.